Hello and welcome to this video, Performing 5G NR Compliant GSM Channel Power and Spectrum Emission Mask Measurements with Keysight's PathWave Vector Signal Analysis Software, also known as the 89600 VSA. 3GPP's RF requirements define the transmitter and receiver characteristics of a base station or device. For transmitter tests, 3GPP defines requirements for the wanted signal transmitted from the base station and device, but also for the unavoidable unwanted emissions outside the transmitted signal. The requirements are specified in three parts: output power level, transmitted signal quality, and unwanted emissions. The 89600 VSA is well known across the industry for its powerful signal quality measurements. In this video, I'll be talking about the new VSA PowerSuite measurement application to perform the unwanted emissions measurements, in particular, the adjacent channel power and the operating band unwanted emissions, also known as spectrum emission mask. I'll start with a single carrier signal and move on to a non-contiguous carrier aggregation signal to perform a cumulative ACLR measurement. Starting off with ACP measurement, there is a standard specific presets which will open a context window to configure the signal. We only need to configure this once. Same signal configuration will apply to the spectrum emission mask and the 5G demodulation measurement, as we will see shortly. This is a downlink test model 1.1 signal, so I will use that as the name. I'll set the carrier frequency, the bandwidth, and numerology. As you can see, all the test models are supported by the VSA. Under the advanced settings, you can set the limit mask for the frequency range, the base station type, and the base station category. So the VSA sets the correct pass-fail limits as defined by 3GPP for conformance testing. For ACLR, the adjacent channel can be a 5G NR, a wideband CDMA, an LTE, or a mix of those. Once you have the right settings, you can go ahead and apply the context to the ACP measurement. Now the measurement is configured accordingly with the correct pass-fail limit as defined by 3GPP. For this signal configuration, 3GPP's limit for the adjacent channel is minus 45 dBc. Here I'm measuring minus 55 dBc, resulting in a 10 dB margin. So it's returning a pass. With some of the hardware platforms, VSA provides noise correction to improve the dynamic range, in this case, a 3 dB improvement with a performance of minus 58 dBc. As I mentioned, the limits are all configured automatically based on the parameters set in the context window. You don't have to set this up, and it will show you here what those limits are for both the adjacent and alternate channels. Using the multi-measurement capability of the VSA, I'm going to add spectral emission mask measurement, and I will apply the exact same configuration. With just a single click, I have the spectral emission mask measurement per 3GPP's requirement. The offsets and limits are set automatically based on 3GPP's definition, and the test passes. I'm now going to add another measurement, in this case to perform the transmitted signal quality or the EVM measurement, and apply exact same setting for this measurement. With a single click, you can see EVM frequency error plus a lot more results. As you can see, VSA allows you to perform adjacent channel power, spectral emission mask, and EVM measurements simultaneously using the exact same configuration. Once you configure the parameters under the context window, you can apply it across different measurements. The next demo is performing cumulative ACLR measurement. For base station operating in non-contiguous spectrum, there are some additions to the RF requirements. The non-contiguous transmission consists of two sub-blocks with a sub-block gap in between. I'll go ahead and do a similar configuration using the context window, but now for a non-contiguous carrier aggregation. I have two 100 MHz wide non-contiguous component carriers with a gap between them. I will use the same test model 1.1. It is a TDD duplex mode. In the case of non-contiguous carrier aggregation, adjacent channel power also applies to inside the gap. For a small gap where the adjacent channels overlap between the two sub-blocks, a cumulative ACLR requirement is applied. In this example, inner offset C is not overlapped, but inner offset D is overlapped, where contributions from both component carriers are accounted for in the cumulative ACLR limit. All of the offsets, both the outer and inner offsets and the limits, are all configured per 3GPP's definition. You don't have to set up any of these parameters. It's all done for you by the application. Same noise correction can be applied to improve the dynamic range. And similar to the single carrier case, we are also gaining a 3 dB improvement here. In summary, the 89600 VSA software now provides a PowerSuite measurement application to perform 3GPP compliant adjacent channel power and spectral emission mask measurements with a simple and easy to use user interface. These measurements can be made using any of the supported hardware platforms or measurement front end you're going to use to provide data to the VSA. This means you can now perform a 3GPP compliant adjacent channel power and spectral emission mask measurements using oscilloscopes for the first time. Also, it can be used with Keysight System View simulation software to compare simulation data with a measurement data. To learn more and to download a free trial, visit us at these websites.